Why does it feel like I never went to sleep? It is July 4th, 2016, 6:45 a.m. Yeah. Welcome to the world of being a pyrotechnician, my friend. Oh. One more day. We got to get through today. All right, let me move my car. I'll get the truck out and we'll put my car back. Today, as you see, this is what I was saying in the video I made yesterday. I have a truck here at my house. I have to bring the Ridgefield today because today's show is so big. It takes two trucks of equipment. All right, let me, I got to move cars around. We are all up bright and early, somehow.
Why do we do this? I'll never know.
Okay. Got the truck out of the driveway. My wife's gonna follow me. My wife and my stepdaughter behind me. Okay. My cousin Anthony's gonna go with me. I'm driving, so I'm not going to be able to film and take pictures, so that's yours. Okay, here we go. 7 a.m. I'm a little bit behind. I wanted to leave here at 6:30, but as long as we're there for 8 o'clock, because Kevin's showing up at 8, I said I wanted to get there at 7:30. Anyway, I'm on the way to Ridgefield High School for the 2016 4th of July fireworks. I have truck number 2. It's only equipment, obviously. No hazmat, no explosives. Just equipment, racks, and the lumber, the strapping. And I think I also have in the truck. I also have the 8-inch, 8-inch mortars. So, I'll tell you what I didn't bring though. I didn't bring a shovel. So hopefully they have a couple there, or Kevin has them. I don't have a shovel in my truck. All right, I'll let you know what happens. We're on the way. We are on the way to Ridgefield. All right, we are getting close to high school. Hi. We made it. Something tells me I'm still the first one here, even though I'm an hour later than I planned on. Okay. We have made it on site to Ridgefield High School. I have to go and open up the gate. I am the first one here, even though I'm like an hour later than I planned on. It's just about 8:30. It's 8:27 a.m. I wanted to be here at 7:30 and have this whole truck unloaded before Kevin gets here, but I'll probably still be able to do that because he ain't here yet either. All right, let me get in this fence. Alrighty, there's Christine. Anthony's coming back down after buzzing me in, and we have made it. He's going to the little boys' room.
And even though I'm...
It's not dark enough to hide behind the tree yet.
Even though I'm later than I wanted to be, I'm still the first one here. Maybe I should give Kevin a wake-up call.
Ah, it's too early in the morning for this.
Okay, so here's what I got on my truck here. We have the 8-inch mortars, 6-inch racks, a few of them, and then it looks like mainly 5-inch racks. So the 8-inch guns, a couple of 6s, Kevin's got most of the 6s, and then I got a bunch of 5s and then lumber. So let me get these pipes unloaded. Then I'm going to back the truck up and start dropping these 6s and 5s out in the field before Kevin gets here with his truck. Yeah, just put them right there. Stand them up by the barrels right now. We're not going to set those up just yet. I just got to get them off the truck.
I gotta get to them. I can't climb home. Three racks left. My truck is unloaded. Does that mean my work is done for today?
Yeah.
I doubt it.
Nails.
Okay. Look at this. I'm sweating already. All right. My truck is unloaded completely. The racks, the strapping, the 8-inch mortars. Everything's completely out. So I back the truck up here out of the way. And now we're waiting for Kevin and the rest of the crew. Here you go. Got everything out of there. I'm empty. Come on, crew. Where are you? Don't let me down. I'm working on less than 2 hours sleep here. Third straight day in a row for shows for me here. Where is everybody? All right, we're gonna get our personal gear out of our vehicle and set up over here. So stay tuned. Okay, we are as far as we can go right now. I'm loaded. My truck, I unloaded our personal van with all our gear, and there is no one else here. So now we sit and we wait for Kevin. And hopefully we got some crew coming today.
I'm going to wet these.
So what I think I'm going to do until he gets here, since I've been working on less than 2 hours sleep right now, is I'm going to lay down until Kevin gets here.
And he makes fun of me for bringing a blanket. What do you need to bring a blanket for? And who's the one who's sleeping on it?
Hey, we got Kevin's truck opened up. Start taking off his stuff. Dropping it over here. Yeah, right there is good. And then we'll start unloading racks off his truck.
And this is how he moves on 2 hours sleep only.
The truck.
What?
This is how slow he moves on 2 hours sleep.
Hi, Maria.
Connecting it. You could climb, I can't.
I'll climb, okay.
You're gonna need help with those other ones up there, huh?
Yeah, once I get to the ones that are stacked to the roof, I can't. You gotta ask whoever has the truck.
Yeah, so how many are out here? 4, 8, 9, 10, 12.
I don't like those ones.
All right, we're starting to lay out the wood. We're going to start building racks. We even got Carl now on the show. Carl just showed up. So we got an extra body. Barbara's son Brian showed up, so two extra bodies. All right, this is going to be my area down here, so I'm going to end up starting to build down here. All right, we're making progress. We got Joe, Maria, Christine, Ed, Carl, and myself building pods for the body of the show. We have Barbara, Brian, Anthony, and Kevin on the finale. I gotta take a 2-minute breather. I gotta go get some water. It is brutal out here today. Scorcher. We're getting there. We are almost completed with the building. The truck with the product has just arrived. And we're almost done with the build, so that's almost on cue. As you can see, so we'll begin to load the product shortly. Like I said, the truck just arrived and putting all the boxes right there, sorting everything out. Fire marshal's got to do his count, make sure everything is in order, and then we'll be able to start loading this up. All right. Brian has begun to fill the barrels with the 8-inch guns.
That's Bob's car.
As you could see, one mortar in each barrel, and they got to be filled up with sand. All right, you get the idea. All of these barrels gotta be full. As he fills them up, we pull the truck up down the line. And here comes Ed. He's gonna help him. Pull it up.
Get in and pull it up.
Yeah.
Enough worry.
You got it.
One,
you,
I can do the other.
You tell me when. Stand by. I gotta move the truck. As you can see now, I'm in the dump truck. Gotta move the truck every time they fill a barrel, pull it up, down the line. Meanwhile, Joe with Ray, the driver of that truck, are starting to put the boxes of explosives in the bed of the pickup truck, and then we're using the pickup truck to jockey them around into position, starting with finale and then with the preloads. It's easier than trying to move these box trucks all over the site. And just move them around with the small pickup truck there. So you can see my wife Christine starting to lay out the shells for the finale. Her and Barbara, Bob and Kevin will work on finale. I'll be back out there with the preloads. As soon as I'm done helping them move the truck, taking the advantage of the little breather here, just moving the truck around. All right. It is 4:23 p.m. So we're making good time. We still got almost 5 hours before showtime. So we'll be fine. And just right. Pull it up.
Yep.
Tell me when.
Going. Good. Good. Get out of these buckets.
What?
Get out of the air conditioning and come move the buckets for us.
Oh. You're going to make me get down off this truck? My legs aren't that long.
Christ.
Holy Christ. How'd you know I was enjoying the AC?
Because I moved it this morning and it was on and it was nice.
I'm enjoying this little break here, moving the truck with the AC going. I was telling you it was a very warm day. Well, there you go, 90 degrees Fahrenheit. This show is always hot. 4th of July is always that one of the hottest days we do. So as they're in the bed of the truck, shoveling the sand, I'm enjoying a little nice cold AC going here. Hey, come on, I'm getting old. I've done hundreds and hundreds of shows over the last 23 years. I deserve a break. All right, they are almost done. Down the last bucket. You can see we're all good. So, I don't have to move the truck no more. We'll be laying out the boxes of shells for me to start loading down there very soon. Ed just took the first load down there, starting with the sixes. They're starting on the finale here.
And I need 10 for the... No, I need... No, I have 30 shells. So I have 6 strings for here. And 2 for the opening. So you're looking for 8 strings.
Really, Maria holding an 8. All right, we have all the shells now laid out, and we're loading. I'm going to be loading my 3s. As I said, Barbara, Kevin, Christine, and Maria working on finale. I'm on 3s and this end of 4s. You got Brian and Joe working on 4s and some 5s on that end. You got Ray, Carl, Ed working on 5s and 6s. And Anthony building this final 3/4 pod before he takes a well-deserved break.
I'm like McDonald's. I deserve the break today.
Yes, you do. He's
after 3 days of this.
Hey, we get a few days of break before we have 2 back-to-back shows next weekend.
And luckily,
for the upcoming weekend, it's already today's what, Monday? I don't even know what day it is anyway. It's Monday. 4 more days, we have a show on Friday. So the Milford show that got postponed from July 1st.
This is national rights.
And then on Saturday, we have a Bristol Blues baseball game show. But this is the granddaddy of them all that we do. This is like the show. Although, let me tell you, last night,
that was a match to this one.
Yeah. That Woodway Country Club, that was an awesome show. We rocked Darianne last night, let me tell you. That was the biggest applaud and cheer from a crowd that I've heard in a very, very long time. We rocked Darianne, Connecticut last night. Kudos to us. As you can see, we're all loading shells.
Shade day.
Something like that. Hi, Dom.
Hi, Robert.
Well, since you're standing here.
Oh, sure. Make me work.
Yeah. The strings are really, really... Look how short the strings are. They're not that long.
No.
It's real hard to load these by yourself.
This is Maria's first time working on the finale.
Okay, you make it sound like I'm like five.
And she's working on it with me.
Mother and daughter. It's a family affair. Okay, Ed is now loading the opening. Just about all of our preloads are done. I'm gonna start rubber banding. Okay, we are completed, on this end with the body of the show. They're just finishing up the finale. Hi, Anthony.
Hi, honey.
Hi, everybody. Got a little wave going there on the finale. Okay, let me give you a quick walkthrough. Here's what we have. This is the opening. This is Carl. Hi, Carl. Okay, we have 3-inch. The 3-inch are all triples. We have 4-inch. 4-inch are doubles and singles. We have lots of 4-inch. These are the 4-inch wooden racks, and these are the 4-inch metal racks. The wave of the future, right here. Now we go into 5-inch. 5-inch wooden racks. Now we have 5-inch metal racks. Now we go into 6-inch wooden racks. And then finally into the 6-inch metal racks. And as you can see, everything is loaded, tucked, and banded. So we are ready, completely 100% ready to go down here with the body of the show. The crowd is over there. And behind the bandstand, behind the building there. So again, this is our setup here at Ridgefield. And now I'll take a walk on down and see the progress on the finale. And the 8-inch should be all loaded up and ready to go also. I will be working, as I always do, down on this end, starting out on 3-inch and working into the 4s. So what's probably going to be my area are going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these racks right here, and we're going to have Joe in here, 4s and some 5s, And we're going to have Ed on some fives and sixes. And then if anybody else wants to light, they'll pair up with us, such as my stepdaughter Maria did with me last night. I'll share a flare with anyone that wants to light some of this stuff. And have a blast here on 4th of July, 2016. All right, let's go check out and see how they're making out on the finale. All right, over here on the 8th, they're all loaded. These are going to be shot electrically. You could see Kevin and Ray right now plugging in the electric igniters inside the module. So all of these 8-inch shells will be fired electrically, and also the finale is fired electrically. Let's go see how they're making progress on the finale. Wow, you do have sunburn.
You'll be putting cream on the other night.
You didn't put enough spray, and it must have came off with that rag, that water you had on that rag. Okay, it looks like they're making good progress here with the finale.
So you're going to tie it all together. Sure, you'll find some and then blowing around.
I know I will.
Okay, just as they were doing over there with the eights on the finale, this is all electric. So they're running the wires over to Anthony, and Anthony is plugging in the electric igniters into a module. Right, Anthony?
Correct.
All right, buddy.
Okay, so this is 12.
Correct.
And we gotta get the new box.
Correct.
They are, Barb. They're tied around the tube.
All right, yeah, that's good.
One of these, Mom?
Okay.
Yes, please.
So, pretty much, my work is done. I got a little downtime until showtime. So stay tuned as the day continues here at Ridgefield High School for 4th of July, 2016. All right, tonight's view, it's gonna have to be like this because this is such a big show the way it's set up in a line. I'll have Christine man the tripod tonight. I'm gonna start out here. I'll be here on the threes, and I guess as I work down, you just turn the tripod, pivot it like that, and well, maybe she could go back and forth and during the show and get a little bit of everybody. But it's gonna be about it. So anyway, that's gonna work. But it'll start out here. All right. Hopefully we'll get a little dinner in a while before we shoot the show. Stay tuned. All right. It's 8:30 p.m. We just got through eating dinner. So the show's going in 45 minutes, shoot about 9:15. We're all set up. Last thing that needs to be done is tin foil put over the finale. We had to wait until they did the continuity check. And everything is an all go. So we're gonna cover up the finale with tin foil so it doesn't go prematurely. As you can see.
Start lighting up there. Start lighting up. Ed, start lighting up there.
God damn, that's fun.
All right, there you go. Oh, what was that? A big thanks to Carl. He was moving my tripod around for me. Thank you, man. Good job.
All right.
Those fives don't do it.
They turn on the lights.
No, I'm so glad.
They got me a water. We got to wait.
I've been facing that.
About 15 minutes or so for this stuff to cool down.
Well, I hit my back. I'm sure there's marks on my coat.
Oh, man.
No, I heard the hustle.
Were you down that end or no?
Yeah. I watched it jump up and I just seen the flash.
I don't know if you could see me. I'm winded. We had a couple of low ones tonight.
Dom, all those low ones were fives.
Yeah, fives? Well, I knew one of them was one, but I was down that end.
You'll see it.
It popped right.
A fire pot will just go up and
my whole body's going.
And I got hit with all the debris.
It goes up.
But as you see, we're in full protective gear. So even when you have one go low like that, here I am with all my fingers and toes and every other appendage. So that just means we did everything right. We're in our full safety gear and we do things right.
I don't want to see it go off.
All right. Stand by until this stuff cools down. We check it. Once we get the all clear, we'll start tearing this puppy down.
I didn't have any plugs, though. It's right here.
We again opened up the skies. Look at that. It is raining. I gotta put the cameras away. Cover up Kevin's. Ah, shit, it's pouring. I gotta put these cameras away. Just out of nowhere, the sky opened up. I didn't even know it was supposed to rain. Shit. All right. We're all cleared. All right, we're all cleared. We're gonna start the tear down, but obviously I can't have the camera out in the rain. It's raining. As you could see, we opened up the skies. So I'll film when I can, but right now it's raining, so the camera's going away. Okay, all hands working, even some new hands. we're gonna try to get this thing torn down as quick as possible because we have rain falling. I didn't even know it was supposed to rain. We opened up the skies with our fireworks, so I'm not going to be filming much of the teardown because, one, we want to get out of here, but, two, now we have rain falling. So we got to try to get this torn down as quick as possible, so the filming is going to be limited right now. How you doing down here, Ed?
I'm good.
Hey, we have...
The sixes are all broke. I'm just doing the
plants
now.
Okay. We have the magical power. We opened up the heavens. We are working in the rain on this 4th of July night. I tell you, it feels good right about now. After working all day, it feels good. But this is a pain in the ass. Well, yeah, we gotta. All right, it is really pouring rain right now out here. I can't keep the camera out long. I'll ruin my $1,000 digital camera. You can see we are all soaked. Right, Carl?
Exactly.
All right, we have everything unnailed and unclamped. We just gotta wait for the truck to start backing up. We'll start loading this. We're gonna get this thing picked up really in a hurry tonight.
Yeah.
All right, we are loading racks into the truck. We're gonna have this, I think, broken down tonight in record time.
My hands are all sticky.
Just hold it for a minute.
Greg,
out of there.
Mom. Mom. Mom.
Go back the truck up. Wait.
Okay.
Come on back.
Took that board.
This is what I like when Brian's adrenaline kicks in. He looks like me 20 years ago. We're getting there. Okay, all the threes from the finale are on Kevin's truck. Now I gotta go get my truck, put it in there for the fives and fours. Long day. It's been a long weekend. Hell week almost over though. Looks like I'm gonna survive another one. I'll understand why we call this Hell Week. Ah, what they put in here? Hold on. Okay, stand by. I gotta move trucks now. Hang on. All right, they're getting the last of the racks. I haven't been filming much because we have been working in pouring rain. They're getting the last of the racks and we'll be out of here. Unbelievable. I didn't even know it was supposed to rain tonight. But 5 minutes after the show, sky opened up. And we have pouring rain, as you can see. All the racks are all picked up or raked up. They're just picking up the debris, putting in the garbage bag. This is the last of Kevin's stuff going on the truck now, and they're shutting the lights. Oh!
Dominic, what's the day?
It is gonna get like black in a second here. Wow, just in time. You just got to see the last of it before they shut the lights. We got one light left. If that goes out, you won't be able to see in front of your face here. All right, well, that's pretty much it, because now you can't see nothing. I'll be leaving the site in just a couple of minutes. Well, that's it. Now they shut the rest of the field lights. So all I got is my car headlights as they get the rest of Kevin's equipment. I can't believe they shut the lights before we were out of here. Unbelievable. All right, give me a minute and we'll be out of here.
Okay, just getting ready to leave. I'm gonna follow Kevin. My truck's going back to my house. I can't get it back up to New Hampshire. John dropped it off to me on Friday. I don't know if John's gonna pick it up or someone's going to come to my house and pick it up, but I can't get it to New Hampshire, I'll tell you that, because I gotta go to work tomorrow, so I can't get this thing to New Hampshire. All right, anyway, We're leaving the site. It is 12:56 a.m. So just about 1 a.m. That is it. 4th of July over for 2016. Hope everyone enjoyed Hell Week, all my videos, and all the fireworks shows that we did. So from Ridgefield, Connecticut, I am saying thank you for watching and good night.